students, today we are going to learn about the topic respiration in organisms. See children, for our living, all the living organisms perform different processes, life processes like respiration, reproduction, excretion, digestion. These are the different processes taking place in all the living organisms. So, the most important process is respiration. For any organism to be live, it needs air, water and food. These are the three important basic needs for any living organisms to stay alive. Hence, we'll see what is respiration now. See children, breathing, it is a process of taking in air and leaving out air. So, what is that we are taking in? See, oxygen. We take in oxygen and leave out carbon dioxide. So, air is a mixture of gases, but we take in along with the oxygen even other gases like carbon dioxide, nitrogen, water vapor and other minute amount of different gases enter into our body. But oxygen is the main gas which is needed by our body, and we leave out carbon dioxide, along with it other gases are also will be moving out of our body. So mainly we talk that we take in oxygen and leave out carbon dioxide. So this is a process of breathing. So here you can also define that taking in air, it is called as inhalation. Taking in air is also known as inhalation or inspiration. So during the process of inhalation, we take in oxygen, and leaving out carbon dioxide is called as exhalation or expiration. So, inhalation is the process of taking in oxygen and exhalation is the process of leaving out carbon dioxide. So, during this process, what is going to happen? We'll see now. See, in broad terms, we can define breathing as respiration. So, what is this process of respiration? So, when we are taking in oxygen, there occurs different processes in our body. So, we take in food and that food will be converted into glucose in our body. So, during this process of respiration, what is happening? Whatever the oxygen we are taking, it helps in breaking down of this glucose. So, when we are taking in oxygen, the glucose present in our body, it breaks down to release carbon dioxide and water. So, this process of breaking down of glucose into carbon dioxide and water is called as respiration. Yes? So, you can observe during this process of respiration, carbon dioxide is evolved from, that is removed from our body. Yes? Next, we'll see respiration rate. See, what is respiration rate? From the time of our birth till death, we respire all the time till our lifetime. Throughout our life, from the birth till our death, we breathe, will not stop at any moment. So, this is a process compared to other different processes, basic processes in our body. Respiration is a process, it takes place throughout our life. Even during your sleep also, you respire, you can observe. So, here we respire through our lungs. Yes, they are present in our chest region. That is, this is the thoracic part and this is the abdominal part. In the thoracic part, in the part of the chest, we can find lungs through which the respiration process takes place. So, during this respiration, we take in, as we have said, so how can we define respiration rate? The process of breathing in and breathing out per minute is called as respiration rate. So this respiration, how many times you breathe in and breathe out, is called in a minute, is called as respiration rate. So approximately around 12 to 16 breaths per minute we respire, and it changes from age group. In children, when you observe, it takes place very fastly. That means it is more than 12 to 16, that is around 40 to 44 times they breathe in and breathe out per minute. Yes, and also during the exercise, when you are running or playing very fastly, or you are climbing the steps, also you can observe the respiration rate will be very fast. Yes. Now we'll see breathing process in different animals. See children, like human beings, even other animals, whether they may be living in water, land or trees, everywhere, every organisms breathe like human beings. See, they have different respiratory organs. Now we'll see different organisms, how do they breathe. Yes, see, first one, fishes. See, fishes, where do they live? Yes, fishes live in water. So how do they respire then? From where does they get the oxygen? See children, they live in water. So the oxygen dissolved in the water will be entering into the fishes. So here, fishes have gills on either side of the body. They respire through, the water enters out and in through the mouth, and whatever the oxygen along with the water into the body of the fish, they will be taken. The oxygen will be taken by the gills and respiration process takes place. So gills are the respiratory organs in fishes. Next one, frog. Frog has the ability to live. It can live in water, on land and under the ground also. So it has three different respiratory organs. Gills. So the frog, when it is in the larval stage, that is tadpole. So when it is in the larva, that is tadpole stage, it looks same as a small fish. So but it is not a fish, it is a frog. It can live in water and land also. Hence it is called as an amphibian. So when the frog is in the larval form, that is tadpole stage, it respires through gills. Yes. Next, when the frog lives on the land, they will be respiring through the lungs. And when the frog undergoes under the ground estivation, it undergoes estivation and hibernation. That is two times it undergoes into the ground and it lives under the ground. You can see the skin of the frog, it will be moist. Why? Because it respires through its skin. So frog has three respiratory organs. When it is in the larval form, it respires through gills, and when it is on the land, it respires through lungs, and when it is under the ground, it respires through its skin. So even the earthworm also respires through its skin. When you observe the skin of the earthworm also, it is moist. The small holes, pores present on the skin, it makes the exchange of gases takes place through the skin in earthworm. Next, cockroach. See, cockroach on the backside, you can see the small holes are present. They are nothing but spiracles. The network of spiracles are nothing but trachea. These are the respiratory tubes on which they are present on the backside of the body of the cockroach. So see, these trachea are the respiratory organs in cockroach. Next, we will see respiration in plants. See, respiration in plants, even the plants also respire like us human beings and other animals also. See, plants, you may be mistaken that people think that plants produce oxygen. See, if they are producing oxygen, then what is the gas which is taken by the plants during respiration? Don't confuse, children, don't confuse between respiration and photosynthesis. See, plants has the ability to produce food. So the process of producing food by the plants is photosynthesis. During the process of photosynthesis, it takes in carbon dioxide and it produces the glucose as a food material. But during the process of respiration, even the plants also take in oxygen and leave out carbon dioxide. Yes, plants also respire like us. So they take in oxygen and leave out carbon dioxide through what they are going to respire. On the leaf, you can observe in plants, on the leaf, you can find small pores are present. You cannot see with our eyes. When we observe under the microscope, you can see the small pores on the leaf. These are called stomata. So, stomata are present on the leaf through which gaseous exchange takes place by the process of transpiration. So, the process of gaseous exchange takes place in plants through the process of transpiration. Even on the stem also you can find bark, a small pores are present. These are nothing but lenticels. On the stem, the plants respire through lenticels. On the roots also you find on the root hair small pores through which they are going to respire. So in this manner even the plants also respire.